Montenegro have found a way back to football's main event.
We missed the World Cup in Japan and Korea. We missed Euro Cup in Portugal, so it was really important for us to get there. So we were thinking about results more than about the beauty of the game. No?
They qualified by building a defensive brick wall, conceding just one goal in 10 qualifiers, which left them unbeaten on top of their group ahead of Spain.
We have our style. Other people told us we play defensively, but we score also 16 goals, so it's not so bad. And of course, it's a fantastic thing when you don't concede many goals, give you a lot of confidence. And we are the fighters, we are the team who is fighting 90 minutes for the result, just the result, and that's it.
The final match had added poignancy as they played neighbours Bosnia for a place at the World Cup finals. So it was indescribably tense from the very first minute.
Yeah, it was a great game. It was a lot of emotion. And for me, it's the most important game out of my life, you know, because when we started this qualification, everything was without the confidence. The people didn't believe in us, you know, very negative. And then the game from game, we get attention, we get confidence. And finally, against Bosnia, it's of course different because it's former Yugoslavia as well. And we have all these stupid things, war and political things. But the game, like a game, was amazing. And we scored a goal, I scored a goal. And I think you have to be there to feel that that passion of people. It's something amazing I never seen before.
And Matija Kecman's goal sends Serbia and Montenegro to the German final.
Matija Kecman is their key goal scorer, and with a defence so solid, one goal from the Atletico Madrid striker is usually enough.
First of all, he's fast. He's fast like a wind. And he's obsessed with the goal. And obsession sometimes in real life, it's not a good thing, but in the football, it's, especially if you're obsessed with the goals, it's really, it helps you.
Both the prolific Kecman and Milosevic himself, their top scorer of all time, were dropped at least once during qualifying as coach Ilija Petković sought to establish team spirit above individual egos.
It was a very difficult moment for us, but Serbia and our former Yugoslavia never had this atmosphere what we have at the moment. I think this disrespect between each other, because it really doesn't matter who play, where he play, how many trophies he get, how much money he earns. Nothing is important, just the team. So I think all the players accept when they have to sit on the bench, then that's really important.
We don't have strong individuals like we did before. Now I think we are stronger as a team. We are united and we do have a great atmosphere, and we do have a great relationship between ourselves and also the relation between the players and the coach.
They'll need this attitude in Germany when they take on Argentina, Holland and the Ivory Coast in Group C.
They call in a group of the dead. Yeah, but my answer to that is they call in that group of the dead because we are there as well. I don't think we should be afraid of anybody.
To be honest, I was happy. When you play Argentina and Holland, the World Cup, it cannot be better, you know. It's better to play Argentina than to play Togo, for example, because you have no pressure. If you lost, nobody will say nothing. If you win, you're a hero.
Around 1 million Serbs live in Germany, guaranteeing full crowds and vocal support, while the players themselves are quietly confident they could surprise a few people in June.
Well, if we get through the first round, which will be really difficult, then there are no limits.
I think when you pass the group, then everything is possible. You know? I think that all teams are a bit afraid of us and they respect us, because football is just a game and just 90 minutes, so everything is possible.
Here comes Serbia and Montenegro again. Koraban! And that's 5-0.
After the break...